In the day's other news, federal officials say that a Saudi gunman who opened fire at a U.S. naval base in Pensacola, Florida last December had ties to al-Qaida. The Saudi officer killed three sailors before being killed himself. FBI Director Christopher Wray says that data recovered from the gunman's cell phone shows links to al-Qaida's branch in Yemen, known as AQAP.
He wasn't just coordinating with them about planning and tactics. He was helping the organization make the most it could out of his murders. And he continued to confer with his AQAP associates right up until the end, the very night before he started shooting.
Director Wray and Attorney General William Barr both sharply criticized Apple for not helping unlock the gunman's smartphone. It took FBI agents 4 months to break the encryption. Attorney General Barr also says that he does not expect criminal probes of former President Obama or former Vice President Biden. President Trump has claimed that they may have committed crimes related to launching the Russia investigation. Barr dismissed that claim today as he discussed U.S. Attorney John Durham's review of the investigation.
As to President Obama and Vice President Biden, whatever their level of involvement, based on the information I have today, I don't expect Mr. Durham's work will lead to a criminal investigation of either man. Our concern over potential criminality is focused on others.
President Trump said later that he's surprised that Barr is not planning criminal probes of Obama and Biden. Democrats say that the Friday night firing of the State Department's inspector general may be linked to a Saudi arms deal. Representative Elliot Engel, chair of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, said today that Inspector General Steve Linnick was investigating the $7 billion deal. President Trump says that he does not know Linnick, but Secretary of State Mike Pompeo wanted him fired. We'll explore this further later in the program. A federal prosecutor who oversaw cases against two Trump allies could be getting a big promotion. It is widely reported that U.S. Attorney Tim Shea will take over the Drug Enforcement Administration. Shea had helped push for a lighter sentence for Roger Stone, a Trump friend and advisor, and for dismissing criminal charges against Michael Flynn, the former National Security Advisor. In Israel, a Jewish extremist was convicted today of murdering an 18-month-old Palestinian boy and his parents. The court found the defendant threw firebombs into the family's West Bank home as they slept in 2015. The boy's grandfather welcomed the conviction.
The trial will not bring my family back, but I don't want there to be more children to go through the trauma that we went through. We went through this trauma for 5 years, a whole year at the hospital, and I don't want another family to go through this. Enough already.
Defense lawyers claimed that police used torture to force a confession, but they offered no evidence. Back in this country, voters in Wisconsin who have disabilities or belong to a minority filed a federal lawsuit over the upcoming August primary and November general election. They want more poll workers, as well as absentee ballots for all voters, among other things. Wisconsin held its presidential primary last month, despite fears of the coronavirus. And the year's first named storm in the Atlantic swirled off the coast of North Carolina. Today, the tropical storm named Arthur brought heavy rain and rough surf to the Outer Banks before turning out to sea. Hurricane season doesn't officially begin until June 1st. Still to come on the NewsHour, public health concerns remain as more and more states relax restrictions on public gatherings. The Trump administration fires a State Department watchdog, the latest in its dismantling of oversight. How the pandemic hastens a nationwide move away from aptitude testing for college admissions, and much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.